Workforce Wednesday. Sponsored by Goodwill of South Mississippi.
Welcome to another edition of Workforce Wednesday. We have Kimberly Hall from Goodwill joining us this afternoon to discuss interviewing in the pandemic. Well, Kimberly, welcome back to WXXB Studio. How are you feeling today?
Thank you. Feeling great. Happy New Year.
I know. Happy New Year, too. First time back in since New Year. Yes. So we're just going to jump right on in. I know it's so different now, or I guess in some ways still kind of the same. How would you go about preparing yourself for an interview?
Absolutely.
Or what tips would you give our viewers?
In the pandemic, no less, right?
Yes.
So I want your viewers to know there are jobs that are available on the coast. Really, to get prepared, of course, you want to wear professional attire, whether you're doing a Zoom interview or you're in person. If you do have a Zoom interview, you want to prepare your technology at least 15 minutes in advance just to work out the kinks, make sure you know that everything is working appropriately with audio and visual. If it's in person, show up 5 to 10 minutes early just to kind of prepare yourself to relax and really get set for your interview. We call something star story, situation, task, action, result. You want to have about 3 of those star stories in your back pocket for questions that the interviewer will be asking you. It really sets you up to share your experience, how you've helped the organization move forward in the past, and how you want to help this new organization that you're interested in move forward.
Absolutely. There's so many different things to also consider when doing an in-person versus Zoom interview. I know whenever we come back to the station, so much has changed since the start of the pandemic.
Yes.
I know we're half the social distance in here, be 6 feet apart. And whenever people are going on those Zoom interviews, is there anything that they additionally have to keep in mind versus the in-person?
You know what? Smiling, right? Even through your mask, just smiling. And typically, if you're on a Zoom interview, you don't have to wear your mask unless, you know, it's a panel or something of that sort. But just smile, engage. When you're in person, we can no longer handshake like normal. But really making that eye contact, whether in person or on Zoom, is very, very, very important.
I know, they say smile with the eyes.
Yes,
I hear that
with
all
your
the time
eyes.
Now.
Absolutely.
And then even after the interview, do you have any tips for our viewers on how to follow up with it?
Yes, always follow up with a thank you email or a thank you note that you mail. It really helps you stand out amongst all of the other applicants that may be applying, and it really shows the interviewer that you're interested in the organization and the role that you're applying for.
And whenever you go about finishing it, is there anything else that you want to add while you're actually in the middle of the interview?
Yes, ask questions. Typically the interviewer will ask you at the end of the interview, do you have any questions? Always have some questions prepared. Do your research on the organization so that you can show you understand their culture and what the organization's goals are. Critical things, really.
Absolutely. I know I had to watch a few of our newscasts before I applied for the job. I'm like, I need to see what I'm getting myself into.
Certainly.
Well, Kim, do you have any other tips you can give our viewers today?
Honestly, if anyone wants to learn more about interview tips, resume writing, please reach out to Goodwill at goodwillsms.org. We would be happy to help and coach you along your process in finding work.
Awesome. Well, thank you once again, Kimberly, for joining us here in our studio today. We always love having you for our Workforce Wednesday.
Thank you.